Hello and welcome to High Voltages. In this video, we are going to make an Android app that can subscribe and publish MQTT messages. Like our previous videos, we will be controlling an LED by sending MQTT messages, and we will be getting temperature and humidity from DHT sensor that is connected to ESP8266 by subscribing to the topic. This video is sponsored by PCBWay.com, who are experts in providing PCB services. If you are new to this channel and you don't know what is MQTT protocol, consider watching my last videos or read blog on High Voltages website, in which I have covered how MQTT protocol works, what are the terminologies, and we have used MQTT protocol in ESP8266, Raspberry Pi, Python programming and MATLAB, and have made some cool projects such as data logger, real-time plotting, etc. For this project that we are going to do today, we will be using MIT App Inventor, which is very simple to use, and you can build any kind of Android application in minutes by just dragging and dropping components. You can learn more about them on their website. Okay, let's start by making a layout of our application. First, when you are on MIT App Inventor website, click on Create Apps. It will ask you to log in. You can log in using Google account, and then you will see bunch of projects if you have created before, or you can create a new project and name it. Then you will see a mobile screen where you will drag and drop items from the left menu. And on the right menu, you can change the parameters of those components. In the block menu, you can do the backend development, like how a certain button will behave when we will click on it. Okay, let's start by dragging a vertical layout in our screen, so all the items are vertically arranged. Then we will add a horizontal layout, and inside it, we will add a label to show the title MQTT dashboard. And in the right menu, you can play with parameters to adjust the size, width, height, alignment, etc. Now, let's import our media that we will be using in our application. I have downloaded some images that I want to place in the app. Let's import them one by one. Then let's add another horizontal layout inside vertical one and add image and label. And from the right menu options, change the image and set the label text and sizing, etc. And also, we will make first image clickable, so when we press it, image should be changed and it can send MQTT message. Then let's copy the whole horizontal layout and place it under the first and change the image and text, and similarly copy paste again for the humidity part. Then in the end, I want to place an image for the How to MQTT series, so I can fill the empty space and publicize my channel. Also, if you have not liked and subscribed, please do, so I can make more such videos. Then we will drag a notifier component so we can generate notification alerts in certain cases. Also, we need to download the MQTT extension. Which we can download from Ulysses Roboter's site, and there you will find detailed documentation of the MQTT extension as well. After downloading, extract the extension and import it in the MIT App Inventor and drag it down on the screen. When you select the MQTT extension, you will see a bunch of values that you need to put in order to use the MQTT protocol. So we will put the broker, port, username, password, client ID, etc. in the right menu. One more thing that I almost forgot is we need to add button for connecting to MQTT broker. So I will copy the same horizontal layout and instead of image, I will put button and rename it to connect and change the label text as well. And the layout is ready. Now we need to do the programming part. Let me show you the ESP8266 code that I am using for this project. We wrote that program in our last videos and you can find link to it in the description. So I want to show that we are sending sensor data to temp data topic and we are subscribing to lights topic in ESP8266 and on message turns on the LED. Also, the circuit diagram will be provided in the description, which we have been using in our last videos. Talking about circuits, if you don't want to use breadboard and want a permanent solution, consider PCBWay.com, who are sponsors of this video. And they are experts in providing PCB services, 3D printing, and CNC, etc. They also provide instant quotes. Discounts. Make sure to check their website. Ordering for a PCB is quite straightforward. Now let's be a kid and program our application using block programming. First thing, we will click the button 1, that is connect button, and we will use the button event when the button is clicked. Then we will use if and else block to see if we are already connected to MQTT broker or not. If we are connected, we will disconnect from MQTT broker. Otherwise, we will connect and we will use clean session, which means MQTT does not store any information about subscriptions, etc. Then from the MQTT extension, we will use the event block when the connection state has changed. And using if and else block, we will see if we are now connected or disconnected. If we are connected now, we will change the button text to disconnect and change the text of label as well. And then we will subscribe to our topic using QoS or quality of service 0. Wildcards are also accepted. Otherwise, if we are disconnected, we will change the button and label text. Then we will use event of bulb image when it is clicked. We will see if we are connected to broker or not. If we are connected and the current image is off bulb. we will publish message on topic lights and change the button image and label. Otherwise, we will publish off message and change the image and label. If we are not connected to broker and we are pressing that button using notifier, we will generate an alert that we are not connected to MQTT broker. Then we will use MQTT extension event when we received message, and using if and else block, we will check if we have received message on the temp data topic. We will create a list to store temperature and humidity data. From ESP8266, we are sending data comma separated. So we will split the data using comma as a separator and store both values in data list at index 1 and 2. Then in the label 3 text, which is for temperature, we will show value of temperature. And here we are using join block to combine values of temperature and the degree symbol. Similarly, we will add text to label 4, which is for humidity. And application is ready. Now let's build an APK and run it. You can directly scan QR code to download APK in your Android, or I am using emulator and I will download and run application there. And you can see it working. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe if that was helpful. And I will keep making such tutorials.